Hello all and welcome to the Lucretia Report. I'm Ian and today, could Democrats win back the Senate? There are 35 U.S. Senate seats up for election in 2020, with control of the Senate hanging in the balance. Whichever party wins control of the Senate will be able to control judicial appointments, the federal budget, and control the ratification of international agreements. If Democrats win control of the Senate, they will be able to pass all the bills they passed in the House in the last several months into law. Election protection legislation, the For the People Act, legislation lowering drug prices, Medicaid protection, universal background checks, and more. But if the Republicans maintain control of the Senate, even if a Democrat wins the presidency, they will not be able to pass any of these bills into law. They will not be able to appoint Supreme Court justices or judges to the lower courts, and they will not be able to enter into international agreements with other countries. So just how likely is it that Democrats will be able to retake control of the Senate? Right now, Democrats control 47 seats in the Senate, while Republicans control 53. 35 seats are up for election this cycle, and of those 35, 23 are held by Republican incumbents, and only 12 are held by Democratic incumbents. There are really four paths to winning the Senate. If a Democrat wins the presidency, then Democrats will hold a tie-breaking vote in the vice president and only need to win three seats. But if Donald Trump wins the presidency, then Democrats will need to win four seats to retake control. Similarly, Doug Jones, the Democratic incumbent from Alabama, is severely at risk of losing his seat. If he wins, it'll only take three new seats to get to 50, but if he loses, it'll take four new seats. So the available paths are: A, a Democrat wins the White House and Doug Jones wins re-election. Democrats need to win three new seats. B, a Democrat wins the presidency and Doug Jones loses. Democrats need to win four new seats. C, Trump and Doug Jones both win. Democrats need four new seats. Or D, Trump wins and Doug Jones loses. Democrats need five new seats. So Democrats need to win on the low end, three new seats, and on the high end, five new seats. The most likely scenario, though, is that Democrats will need to win four new seats, so we'll focus there. This map is actually a pretty good one for Democrats. Of the 12 incumbents that Democrats are defending, only one of them, Doug Jones, is seriously at risk of losing his seat. Gary Peters in Michigan will still have to make sure that he runs a good campaign, but he's probably going to win. The Republicans, on the other hand, have a much harder map. They have four races rated as a toss-up. Joni Ernst has an uphill battle in Iowa, and there's even strong challengers in South Carolina, Kentucky, and Texas. We're only going to focus on four races, though, because that's how many Democrats need to win. Let's start with Maine. Susan Collins is defending her seat, which she has held since 1997. Maine is not a red state. Democrats running for president have won Maine in every single one of the last seven elections. Susan Collins has never been a senator at a time when Maine voted for Republicans. Susan Collins has managed to hold on in a blue state for so long, mainly by being viewed as a moderate. She has never really been seen by Mainers as like other Republicans. This has changed. Because of her steadfast defense of Donald Trump's misconduct and her support for Brett Kavanaugh, even amongst multiple reports of sexual misconduct, her image as a moderate who's not like other Republicans has been tarnished. And now Democrats and left-leaning independents in Maine are ready to see her go. In a poll from October, Collins' approval in Maine sat at only 35%, with 50% of people saying that they disapproved of her performance. And this same poll had her losing in a head-to-head matchup against Generic Democrat. And the candidate of Generic Democrat has arguably not run a very good campaign. Maine has no Republican members of Congress. The governor is a Democrat. Both houses of the legislature are controlled by Democrats. Susan Collins is an aberration and not the rule. And I don't know how much longer she's gonna last. Cory Gardner is in a similar situation to Susan Collins, albeit he's not as hated as she is. He's from a state which Hillary Clinton won, Colorado, and which Barack Obama won twice. He's from a state that has a Democratic governor, and he's from the first state in the nation to legalize marijuana. What's more is that Gardner is now up against a very popular former governor of Colorado, John Hickenlooper, a figure who's so popular in Colorado that one analyst said, even though the primaries have not ended yet, that if Hickenlooper gets in, the general starts right away. Gardner is a freshman senator who only won his seat by 2 points. When Hickenlooper was elected governor, he won by 15 points. A poll by the 314 Action Fund put Hickenlooper up against Gardner and had him winning by 13 points. Meanwhile in Arizona, Martha McSally was appointed to fill John McCain's vacant Senate seat after he died, despite the fact that she ran for the other Arizona Senate seat and the people of Arizona rejected her. Now she's up for a 2020 special election. Unlike Maine, Arizona is not a traditionally blue state. Democrats have won it in the presidential only once since 1948. But over the last several years, Arizona has been trending more and more towards Democrats. In 2004, George Bush won it by 55%. But then John McCain and Mitt Romney only won it by 53.6%, and Donald Trump only won it by 48%. Not to mention that when Arizona had a Senate election in 2018, they voted for Democrat Kristen Sinema. And what's more than that is that Sinema was running against Martha McSally. The voters of Arizona voted against Martha McSally a year ago, and there's not a small chance that they'll do the same thing a year from now. Especially since she's up against Mark Kelly, a former US Navy fighter pilot and former astronaut who's pretty universally popular, and who I always mix up with his twin brother Scott, who's also an astronaut. Just remember, Mark's the one with the mustache. Like McSally and Gardner, Tom Tillis is another freshman senator, this time from North Carolina. When Tillis was elected in 2014, he won with only 48% of the vote, the smallest Senate victory in the history of North Carolina. Of these four people, Tillis probably has the best chance of re-election. Donald Trump won North Carolina, it's still a fairly red state, and in a special election for the House earlier this year in North Carolina, which was widely considered to be a 2020 bellwether, the Republican won. That being said, Tillis hardly has an easy time ahead of him. Like Gardner and Collins, Tillis is very unpopular, with approval in his state being in the 30s. And like those other two, he's trailing his Democratic opponent, Cal Cunningham, usually by 1 or 2% in polls. If Democrats can get victories in those four states, Arizona, Colorado, Maine, and North Carolina, they'll retake the Senate in most situations. If Donald Trump loses, they'll retake the Senate whether Doug Jones wins or loses. And even if Donald Trump wins, they'll still retake the Senate if Doug Jones also wins. Well, no. All is not lost. But it does become much harder. Those four states are definitely the easiest ones for Democrats to pick up in 2020. But there are some others that could potentially make a fifth if needed. In 2018, three of Iowa's four congressional districts went to Democrats, and Joni Ernst isn't that popular there. Georgia has two elections, where Stacey Abrams came 1% from the governorship in 2018. There's Texas, where Beto O'Rourke almost won in 2018. And there's even strong challenges to Mitch McConnell and Lindsey Graham and Jamie Harrison and Amy McGrath. We shouldn't count on that, though. We need to make sure that we do everything we can to win those four seats in North Carolina, Colorado, Maine, and Arizona, and to hold on to Doug Jones in Alabama. Because if we can hold on to Doug Jones, then we win the Senate no matter what if we win those four seats. So I'm going to post some links in the description, and I encourage you to follow them. Because if you follow them, they'll tell you how you can help make sure that we win these seats, and with them, the Senate. Sic Semper Tyrannis. Hey everybody, if you enjoyed that, give it a like. You can watch another video here, and please consider subscribing here. And follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I'll see you later.